Okay, so it's very early. It's somewhere about 5 o'clock in the morning, and I'm not normally up this early. But today is an exception because I'm off to Athens this weekend. I'm going to run the Athens Classic Marathon on Sunday, which follows the original route from Marathon to Athens. And I'm just in the middle of sorting all the rest of my stuff out, getting ready. It's a mess. And then we're off to the airport, and I thought I'd bring you along as well, and you can enjoy the weekend with me.
Hopefully you can hear me. I'm talking quite quietly because the terminal is very quiet and I don't want anyone to hear me. About to get on the plane in about 10 minutes time. We're due to go in about half hour. Something has just brought to my attention, and I don't know if you can see it over there. They've got a Christmas tree up. What? A Christmas tree? It's Friday the 9th of November. Why have they got a Christmas tree up? Oh well, I don't know. I'll speak to you from Greece. Greetings from the rooftop of the Euripides Hotel in Athens. I made it despite a Greek strike which took out the metro, but I'm here. I've got a cheeky glass of beer, which I thought I deserved after a long day's travelling, and I've got possibly the best view from a bar that I've ever sat in. I mean, look at this. That's what I'm looking at. Isn't that brilliant? And interesting journey from the airport to get here, because the metro was on strike, so I got the bus. And the bus pulled up at a traffic light. I looked out the window and, oh, there's a Greek car. And I realised, of course there's a Greek car. You're in Greece. But I got here and all ready to go and register for the race tomorrow and meet up with some other runners and have a look round and get ready for the race on Sunday.
Saturday. Good day today, actually. Met with some runners this morning and we went to the Panathinaik Stadium, which was the home of the 1896 Olympics, and is also where the race finishes tomorrow. And then we registered, picked up numbers and everything, got my race kit all laid out, ready for the morning. Gotta be well prepared. I'm on the drink, make sure I'm well hydrated. And I also went up the Acropolis, which was amazing, but slight of an anticlimax. It's a lot smaller than I would imagine. The Parthenon is tiny up close. But a really good day. Saw some lovely parts of Athens that I'd never seen before. And good dinner, lots of pasta, carbo loading. It's only about 6:45, but I've got to get up very early in the morning, 4 o'clock, for breakfast and get ready and everything to leave for the bus to start at 5:30. So it's early to bed for me tonight, no late night, and I'll see you tomorrow in Marathon.
Welcome to Marathon. I hope you can hear me. There's a lot of loud music and things going on. Here we are then in the birthplace of the race. I'm stood behind a building in a corner because it's the only place where it's quiet enough for me to record. It's very early in the morning. Well, early for me. It's not that early really. It's about 7:30 and about an hour and a half to go to the race starts. I've seen some of the route on the way here on the bus. Lots of hills. Not especially looking forward to that, but we're here now and we'll get out there and do it. And all being well, I will see you in 26 miles time in Athens. Made it 26 miles, 385 yards later, and I'm here in Athens. I've had to come away from home because it's just too noisy to film. I have to say that was probably the hardest race I have ever run. Marathon number 11, but the first one with probably a 13 mile uphill climb, and that took it out of me. So I wasn't expecting a quick time, but I'm here in one piece, which is more than can be said for the forerunner of the race. So 2,500 years on, I finished in 5 hours and 28 minutes, which over that course I'm pleased with. Absolutely brilliant atmosphere, and wonderful to say that I finally run from Marathon to Athens and got the medal to prove it. Most important thing now, I'm off to find a beer.
Well, a very long day, but a very satisfying day. I got up at 4 o'clock this morning and left the hotel about 5 after breakfast and sorting my kit out to get the metro to Syntagma, where the bus is waiting to take us to Marathon for the start. Marathon is a lovely place, I have to say that, and completely unlike Athens, all green and lush, and what I saw of it was lovely. But it was about 7-8 o'clock in the morning, and it was full of runners. But it's a lovely place. And the race itself was challenging, very hilly. I wasn't expecting the amount of uphill climb that there was, but it was very satisfying as well on the way. And I saw some interesting things. The amount of people dressed as Greek soldiers, I think it was even one bloke running barefoot, which either he's very mad or has soles of leather on his feet. And the Greek people were wonderful. All along the course, clapping and cheering and shouting bravo, which I can only assume is the Greek for well done. And it was nice at the beginning because there were a few people, and then suddenly you reach Athens and there's this wall of noise. There's no other way to describe it, just people lining the streets both sides, clapping and cheering and waving flags and open their hands out for high fives. Absolutely brilliant. And to run into the Panathinaik Stadium at the end, which was the home of the 1896 Olympics, first modern Olympics, also the end of the 2004 Olympic marathon route, which is the same route that we followed today, and was the end of our race today. That was quite special. And they had the Olympic flag flying, which was quite nice to finish under an Olympic flag, because I don't think I'll ever be able to do it for my country, so that was quite nice. And a rather impressive bit of metal at the end as well. I don't know if you can see that very well on the camera, but quite posh and fancy. And it features the Panathinaik Stadium on the front, which is quite good. And some Greek on the back, I can't read the name, but if anyone can and could translate, that'd be rather good. And then I went to a local taverna to end the evening. Lots of beer and ouzo and moussaka and halloumi and Greek salad and all those things. And it was entirely full of Greeks, all drunk, all singing and dancing. So brilliant end to a brilliant day. And I'm very tired now and I need my bed. So I shall catch up with you tomorrow. Gracias. London. I'm in my overnight stop for the night. There wasn't anywhere I was going to drive home after today. Very, very good day. Sightseeing and then flying back this evening. But I'm walking a little bit like John Wayne now. After a full day walking around on post-marathon legs and then 3.5 hours on the plane. Slightly problematic walking around, but that'll get better. It'll be all right by Wednesday. Absolutely brilliant weekend. Loved every minute of it. Athens was brilliant. It's an absolutely wonderful city. Gorgeous, wonderful buildings. The Greeks are so friendly and happy and welcoming, and really pleased that people are still going out there because Greece is very much open for business. Despite what you see on the news, it's not about that at all. Athens is a wonderful city, and I do urge you to go out there. You won't be disappointed. The race was absolutely brilliant, despite the fact it's very hilly and quite tough. I think I'd do it again. Yeah. In hindsight, I enjoyed it. And yeah, I probably will go out there and do it again. Absolutely loved it. And pleased with the time. A bit slower than I'd like, but now I know what to expect. I can push for a faster time next year. You might have noticed from some of the pictures that was running in aid of charity, the Pancreatic Cancer Research Fund, which is a cause that's very close to my heart. 4 years ago, my dad died from pancreatic cancer, and despite the fact that only 3% of people diagnosed live more than 5 years after diagnosis, it's still one of the most under-researched cancers. And it's very hard to detect. There's no early detection test. If you want to know a bit more, I'll put a link down in the description to their website and you can find out all about it there. If you'd like to sponsor me, that'd be brilliant. There's a Just Giving page that's still open and running, and I'll put the link to that down in the description as well. All that's left for me to say is I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it gave you a little insight into my weekend and the marathon, and hopefully maybe it's inspired you to get out there and do a run yourself. You never know, maybe I'll see you on the start line soon.